Bright city lights from day to midnight, break the clouds and descend from bird flight. Bright city lights.
My name is Marcela, and I'm a newborn open streets activist. I say newborn because I was surrounded by open streets. I was raised in that, on open streets, I like to say. But it really wasn't until this year when the power of open streets became very apparent, particularly in Cape Town for me. I'm Colombian by birth, by passport, and by accent, as all of you can tell. But I came to South Africa many years ago, not quite on a bicycle the way, but I do have my bicycle up there, and I think some of you have seen it. And as I was getting ready for this talk, I was reminded of something a very good friend of mine said to me when I was exploring this idea of open streets in Cape Town a little bit deeper. He said to me, it's so good to follow your heart and try to make a change in the city where you choose to live. And I was very fortunate. I had the choice to live in Cape Town. And when I'm asked how I like to live in Cape Town, how I like Cape Town generally, I don't hesitate to say Cape Town is one of the most, if not the most beautiful city in the world. But then I proceeded to make a statement that a lot of us, especially foreigners, have become accustomed to making. It is sadly so divided. I make no pretense to know what it takes to bridge that divide. As I've said, I'm not South African, and what I know of South Africa and its history is really limited to my university studies and the several years I've spent between Johannesburg and Cape Town. But I can say with confidence that all of us in this room and in this city and this country, not unlike citizens in other places around the world, have access to. And it's a no-brainer. We've all been talking about it today. It belongs to us. It's public space. It's our streets. We own them. So you might be wondering, what is open streets? Some of you might be thinking, is the literal act of opening a street, digging it, constructing, making it wider for more cars and more traffic. I suspect I might be preaching to the converted here when I talk about shared space. Not as radical as what happens on Exhibition Road. Some of you might have been there, where the road is actually shared by everybody, cyclists, buses, pedestrians, skateboarders, without a single sign or a lane on the pavement. But I am speaking about a form of shared space, an opportunity to invite diversity in all forms of transport. It all started a long time ago. Now, Colombia is infamous for our rebel groups. Cyclists are not exception to that rule. And in 1976, a group of cyclists, fed up with traffic and what that meant for safety for cyclists, lack thereof, took over the streets on a Sunday morning. That, over time, has become the most important recreational event in the country, and I dare to say the most iconic event in Bogota. We are proud to say that we don't have sea, we don't have an ocean, but we have ciclovía. And ciclovía is what we call it. It means bicycle path in Spanish. And today, it involves 120 kilometers of road in the city that attracts over a million people. From 6 a.m. until 2 p.m. every Sunday, people come out on the streets. But it's not just about cycling. It's about everything. It's about jogging, walking, dancing, you name it. And Bogota has the world record on the largest number of people performing aerobics on one venue at once, 37,000 of them. So, this is what it looks like.
Aparte de que es un trabajo en donde uno hace deporte, es un trabajo que puedes tener contacto directo con las personas, y eso es muy gratificante. Cuando ves, digamos, le ofreces una actividad a un niño y él te regala una sonrisa, las gracias. Eso es.
So many cities have adopted this. About 100 around the world do one or a forum of open streets, different types. And a Cape Townian open streets, made, designed by Cape Townians, and for all Cape Townians, can become an amazing, very powerful institution, especially for future generations. Open Streets is about public space. It's about encouraging the use and the celebration of public space. So imagine that our kids or us, instead of going to the mall, go to the nearest park. It's not easy to imagine. It's not difficult to imagine. Now, if you have ridden your bicycle or pushed on a skateboard or simply tried to cross the street in the city, you will probably know what it is not to have freedom and safety of movement. Open Streets offers this, and it's happening already. A lot of you may have seen and probably participated in what happens every full moon in Cape Town. Thousands of people get on their bicycles, their unicycles, their roller skates, you name it, and enjoy the city. The success is such that the city is now providing marshals and police presence. What's really interesting about this is that those services were never requested or offered. They just had to be made available, because people were demanding street space. We were demanding open streets, effectively. It doesn't stop there, though. And the real value, at least from my perspective, of open streets is how it builds communities and social cohesion. In Bogota, for instance, you can access the most affluent neighborhoods in the city and the poorest and sometimes scariest parts of the city in one journey, all on open streets. The sustainable transport agenda is also, obviously, it's a bit of a no-brainer, right? You're on the streets and you're not on your car and you're riding a bicycle, you're walking. But there's also an element of exposure. So when we're on the streets, we all of a sudden notice, ooh, there's a bus station here, there's a train station there. Maybe I'll start doing this on a regular basis. I was speaking to an expert on sustainable transport. By the way, I'm not an expert on sustainable transport. I'm just an activist, just to make that clear. But I was speaking to an expert on this subject, and she was saying to me, Cape Town has 1,000 kilometers of paved road. That's a lot. Open Streets is not asking for more. We have enough. And even though only 16 kilometers from that number of kilometers is segregated to non-motorized transports, we can have more. We should have more. But I think what we need to start with is using what we have already. And this is what Open Streets calls for. Open Streets is fun. Some of you might know, and actually I would like to see if anybody knows who, according to Columbia University, is the happiest country in the world in 2012. Any wild guess? Sorry? Bhutan. Well, according to what I read, it's Denmark. So the Danes, apparently, are the happiest in the world. And I like to argue that it is because they use their streets. A lot of bicycles out there, regardless of the weather, people are communicating. And I would say that they effectively have incorporated 24-hour open streets. So yes, open streets equals happiness. The World Cup is a good example in Cape Town, and it's been mentioned today. And the HSRC, for instance, has actually hard data that proves that social cohesion was one of the legacy pieces of the World Cup. And I think even though Open Streets is not a panacea, it builds on that. It helps us to see what else can we do when we all party, walk, cycle on the streets together. But it's a very long-term process. Changing mindsets, social behavior, as we know, takes repetition. And for Open Streets to have the impact that it has had in other places, it has to happen in Cape Town over and over again. So, as I've been talking to many different people, we have different ideas what Open Streets are about, and we know that the geography is difficult here. But imagine, this can happen. The entire city could be linked, and it is linked by streets. This could be Open Streets. But we need to start small, right? So, we've thought about Albert Road, for instance. It connects the Grand Parade in town to a place like the Old Biscayne Mill in Woodstock. But it can go beyond Salt River, along Fort Trekker Road, to the suburbs. You know, the sky is the limit. The streets are the limit, right? And it connects the entire city of Cape Town. So the reason I'm here is because I need your help. I'm a volunteer here and working with a bunch of passionate volunteers as well, but we don't really have an institution behind us, no financial resources, but we have a lot of energy. And what I've found, even though it's difficult and frustrating not to have, you know, what it takes to just organize an event, is that it is coming from the bottom. And so I like for you to do something to join this movement. I want you, after today, to go and find the nearest park in your neighborhoods. And I want you to find two interesting things about it. When was it built? What happens there on a Sunday morning, for instance? Take notes, take photos. This is part of your homework, so I hope you're taking notes. Spot a new street in your neighborhood. Again, don't use your car. Maybe you haven't even been on that street on your car. Take your kids along, get on your bicycle, or just walk and go and identify a building or a site that you've never seen. Why has that been the case? Again, write a couple of reflections, take a couple of photos, and add it to your homework. I will be asking you for it. The last piece is open your street. I challenge you to go out on the sidewalk. Bring your chair to sit there for 20 minutes, watch what happens on your street. Perhaps you want to go a step further and knock on that neighbor's door, that person you've never met. Go and introduce yourself. Organize a little braai, like a good friend of mine did recently in Ops. Have a little braai. What does open streets mean to you? He's a graffiti artist in the making, hopefully. There's an opportunity for your kids to go out there and really physically experience what the street is all about. Take photos, take your notes, and let me know. What does open streets mean to you? After you've done that homework, does the concept resonate a little bit more stronger, perhaps? I'm on Twitter. Put all your photos, all your images on #OpenStreetCT and email me. There's a bunch of volunteers that want to gather all this data, take it to the city to demand open streets. Thank you very much.